UIU File 2008-021. Case File, Ursus Maritimus Incident. Initial Report, electronic copy below as per Federal Records Act. Summary: an event caused by the presence of a heat-absorbing polar bear in Boring, Oregon, resulted in sudden localized climate change, the destruction of private property, and 2 civilian deaths. For information regarding the Boring Agreement between the SCP Foundation, Wilson's Wildlife Solutions, and the United States government, please proceed to the Bureau tab of this file. Event/Locale Preface. Event Discovery: a sudden out-of-season blizzard was detected by meteorological equipment in Portland Recon Camp Bravo. Further information revealed this blizzard to be localized to Boring, Oregon, a city 20 miles from Portland. Strike Team Bravo 1 was dispatched to investigate the unusuality. Locale Summary, Pre-Event. Transdimensional Hotspot US-1221, aka Boring, Oregon, is a convergence of transdimensional waypoints with a US citizen community. The local population regards supernatural events as normal. Area is under SCP Foundation supervision. An organization dedicated to the capture and rehabilitation of supernatural fauna by the name of Wilson's Wildlife Shelter is based out of THUS-1221. Locale Summary, Post-Event. Boring suffered intense snowfall, which quickly melted following the stabilization of weather patterns. Minor flooding persisted for a week following. Efforts to rebuild the Wilson Center and provide disaster relief to Boring are ongoing. Wilson's Wildlife Shelter is now an affiliate of the SCP Foundation. As per the Boring Agreement, the United States government maintains a joint jurisdiction of the area alongside the SCP Foundation and affiliated parties. Creature Description/Capabilities. Codename: the Polar Bear. Physical Description: creature was a polar bear of non-noteworthy appearance. Capabilities: creature continuously absorbed heat in a large radius, reducing ambient temperature sub-zero levels. Heat is converted to light, which radiates from its fur coat. This property was known to be exacerbated by extreme weather conditions. Purpose/motive: unknown/survival. Modus operandi: creature wandered aimlessly through Boring while scavenging for food. Behavior: the creature was highly hostile to UIU agents and WWS members alike. It avoided areas with large civilian populations and overturned a dumpster. Evidence: interrogation record, Timothy Wilson. Begin log. Agent Masters: yes, Mr. Wilson, this is being recorded. You aren't in trouble. You haven't broken any laws. I just want to talk to you about this situation. Wilson: listen, I appreciate all the help the government has given us here, but... Agent Masters: I promise you Sarah will be okay. Wilson: old Al was almost mauled by the polar bear, my center is in ruins, and... gosh, I don't even want to think about Copper. Agent Masters: I'm aware of what has transpired, Mr. Wilson. Will you please cooperate with me? Wilson: fine, but let's be quick about it, please. I need to rally the troops and I don't know how I'm going to talk them out of this one. Agent Masters: how long was the bear in your custody? Wilson: about a week now, I reckon. Agent Masters: how did you house the bear prior? Wilson: we tried keeping it in one of those big old enclosures you see over there, but it didn't pan out well. So instead we kept up in that Neptune cold storage down by Main Street, but... well, you already saw what happened there. Agent Masters: how are you able to afford all this? Wilson: Are you accusing me of something? Agent Masters: no, I would never. Wilson: we get all our money and fixins off of donations and bake sales. We got a real big anonymous donor. They're a guardian angel, I'm telling you. But I don't know if this is going to be able to pay for Sarah's hospital bill. Agent Masters: do you have an... Wilson: I just feel so bad is all. She was just doing her job, pro bono no less, and lending us a hand with that dangerous critter and... gosh, are you sure I can't see her? I just want to talk to her and let her know we're going to cover her expenses. I think I might have to take out another loan, but it'll be a-okay. Agent Masters: Mr. Wilson, please. Do you suspect anyone of being this angel donor? Wilson: I don't know. The donations are anonymous. Now look, mister, it's been real nice, but I'm getting antsy and my folks out there are shaking in their boots, not just because of the cold. I need to go talk to them and tell them this is all going to be a-okay. Agent Masters: very well. Thank you, Mr. Wilson. Note: Mr. Wilson was looking quite distressed during our conversation. No eye contact, a smile from ear to ear, and he was wheezing the whole time. He doesn't seem like the dishonest kind, and his criminal record came up clean. I suspect he might just fear authority figures. Bureau Record: current status of investigation. Creature's remains are in FBI custody. Disaster relief has been deployed to Boring, Oregon, and a cover story of a freak summer cold front caused by global warming has been disseminated. The Foundation was contacted regarding lack of involvement. Case is considered closed. Investigation conclusion. Research into replicating the creature's anomalous properties to recreate polar ice caps is pending approval. New anomalous party registered, Wilson's Wildlife Shelter, pending rename to Wilson's Wildlife Solutions, as per last communication. Formerly operated as an unknowing Foundation puppet prior to Ursus Maritimus incident, in direct violation of USEOCT Clause 14. Footnote. Clause 14 of the United States Extranormal Organization Cooperation Treaty between the Foundation and the United States government disallows either party to sponsor, assist, fund, or otherwise create a group which may compete with or conflict with the other. The Boring Agreement was established between WWS, the SCP Foundation, and the United States government. Key points proceed. Wilson's Wildlife Shelter has been allowed to apprehend and rehabilitate low-threat anomalous creatures appearing within THUS-1221. Wilson's Wildlife Shelter has been permitted to contact the United States Fish and Wildlife Service Anomalous Detachment for assistance, should the SCP Foundation fail to assist the group with capturing a high-threat entity. The United States government holds jurisdiction over paracrimes committed within THUS-1221. This extends to the containment of human and humanoid anomalous entities, as well as objects utilized to commit said actions. The SCP Foundation is to provide Wilson's Wildlife Shelter with monthly funding and as per the organization's budgetary needs. The SCP Foundation is permitted to contain high-threat anomalous creatures appearing within THUS-1221, with the exception of the polar bear responsible for the relevant documentation. The SCP Foundation is prohibited from directly interfering in the affairs of Wilson's Wildlife Shelter, unless requested or deemed necessary in case of emergency. All parties reserve the right to amend the Boring Agreement in case of emergency, so long as said amendment does not interfere directly with the affairs of the others. History of UIU Action. June 21st, 2008, 9:02 a.m. Abnormal weather patterns detected by Portland office. Mobile unit dispatched to investigate. 9:29 a.m. Boring is suffering Arctic blast conditions and intense snowfall. Entrance to town is blocked off by local law enforcement, claiming the situation is handled. 9:32 a.m. First contact established with Wilson's Wildlife Shelter. 9:59 a.m. Wilson's Wildlife Shelter attempt to corner the creature. Creature escapes by destroying a fence and fleeing. Creature is noted to become increasingly bright. 10:12 a.m. Agents DiCarlo and Lopez attempt to tranquilize the creature, but it has grown too bright to hit accurately. 10:20 a.m. WWS personnel Timothy Wilson offers assistance and suggests to combine efforts. 10:58 a.m. Creature is successfully lured towards the Wilson Center. 11 a.m. Agents DiCarlo and Lopez, alongside WWS personnel Timothy Wilson and Albert Westren, attempt to trap the creature within the Wilson Center to facilitate tranquilization. 11:04 a.m. Creature is trapped and becomes distressed, increasing the rate at which it absorbed heat. Agent Lopez fires two tranquilizer rounds. One shot lands. 11:05 a.m. Creature enters a panicked state and destroys an established barricade, attempts to attack Albert Westren. Agent DiCarlo discharges his weapon. 11:32 a.m. Creature explodes, destroying the Wilson Center, killing agents DiCarlo and Lopez, one WWS volunteer by the name of Sarah Gardner, and three other animals. 12:05 p.m. Emergency response crew arrives. Remains of the creature are airlifted to base for dissection. Timothy Wilson was held and interrogated after ensuring his physical health. 2:35 p.m. Boring agreement proposed. 2:59 p.m. Boring agreement ratified.